was little low as compared to the counterparts, even we are talking about Maharashtra or Delhi.
Even the very beginning, when we are alarmed about COVID-19, which is a contagious disease, as a state as a whole, we took a lot of initiatives, preventive measures. We took the help of all the professionals and doctors and all the concerned department to prepare a plan how to go about. The entire road plan was planned, and we planned and we started working in that direction. Even before the lockdown, we tried to cut down most of the activities where there's a high chances of the citizens getting infected. We took a lot of preventive measures. Along with that, subsequently the lockdown was implemented very effectively. And along with that, the preventive is one part. Preventive, a lot of preventive measure was taken. Parallelly, we ensured the facility for the treatment, testing, tracing, tracking, all those things were done very effectively. That was very, very important, because tracing and tracking, this is a contagious disease, we isolated the infected people very effectively. We contained them to very isolation or the quarantine facility, and that's how we were able to manage the situation very well, and we did our best.
So just yesterday we saw a spike, at least about 388 cases. Do you have a prediction of sorts for the next couple of months or so? What do you see?
You know very well, this is all because of the domestic movement. Since domestic now it's our own people, we can't help it. Whether they're infected or not, they're infected. We need to take them. So because of the domestic movement, all this infection rate is increasing. Now it's a time, stop worrying about the numbers. We need to take preventive, that doesn't mean we can take it for granted. Whatever preventive measure needs to be taken, we need to take preventive, and treatment facility need to be provided. Parallelly, we should look at now how best we can revive the economy. That's the most important thing, along with lives. Livelihood also is important. I mean, we are trying our best to ensure livelihood also needs to be addressed very strongly.
We are here at the war room, which is headquartered in the BBMP city limits. We see that this particular war room right behind me has at least about 18 people constantly working round the clock in three different shifts. Now, to give you an overview of Bengaluru, remember Bengaluru is within the BBMP limits. We're talking about the zone-wise positive cases. For example, one particular area, Yelahanka, that I'm talking about has reported at least four different positive cases, whereas the death stands at zero. Now, coming back to West Zone in Bengaluru has reported at least 103 positive cases, and we see that at least two deaths have been reported. Now, this particular display screen clearly talks about the number of cases in various zones. Also, to give you an overall picture of Bengaluru itself, we see clearly so far 398 cases have been reported from Bengaluru urban, and we see active cases at least stands at 152. So far, the recoveries have been nearly 234 and the deaths stand at 12. Now remember, this is the BBMP war room that we're talking about, which focuses only on the places which fall under its limit. Now coming back to the second screen that we're looking at here, is they have analyzed the areas, and clearly they have come and in fact zeroed in on nearly 68 containment zones. Now again, to my left, what you see over here is there's something green which blinks. Now that's called the reported areas, and the red that blinks is called the unreported. Coming back to the map to show you what these green and reds are, if you can see right over here, now these are the containment zones that we're talking about. Now the green which has reported is about the field officers who are deployed in that particular containment zones. Now they have already reported, they've analyzed the situation in that particular containment zone. They have in fact given those details, the data has been analyzed, and that's why it's reporting over there green. Now in the areas that we just saw, which is red, blinking red, now they are still awaiting, the people over here in the war room, they're still awaiting for more and more details yet to come in from these containment zones. Now remember, they have been, now this is the cloud computing network which enables digital data movement, especially from between the war room and also other various sources that have been deployed on the field. Now this was just especially about the BBMP war room that we're talking about. There was in fact another war room which has been set up at the Balabruhi guest house. Now this is a state war room that we are talking about, which focuses entirely just on state. Now this has been especially the war rooms that have been set up exclusively for Bengaluru urban and also for the entire state. Now they have the officers, also the people on the field have come together to ensure, in fact, to analyze the data, also the unique spreaders that we're talking about, and also to see how exactly can they deploy various measures to contain the spread. With video journalist Pradeep, this is Sridhar reporting for Mirror Now in Bengaluru.